theory is a lie agreed upon. His story, a convenient invention of facts to control us and keep us in our place. And my guest today, Barbara Hand Clow, is here to set the record straight, to reveal the sacred knowledge of the universe, and to tell us that we are not approaching the end of the world, but a spiritual evolution if we wake up. Barbara Hand Clow is a best-selling author, a renowned astrologer, and spiritual teacher. She is internationally acclaimed for her work in past life regression, initiatic journeys, and as a ceremonial leader at sacred sites. And she is also a wife and a mother, and she's the character of Boopsy in Gary Trudeau's Doomsbury. And not only has she time traveled through thousands of years of history, she's also come all the way from New York to speak with us. Barbara, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
I want to ask you what time it is. You say that to bring a new future and a new reality, we have to break from our limited perceptions of reality in 3D time and space. Mm-hmm. What do you mean by that?
Well, first of all, we need to really be in 3D time and space. In other words, one of the most profound aspects of my teaching is how much we really need to be right in our present current reality, such as me, wife and mother, as well as writer. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, we're living in a time of accelerated energy. And it's like rays of light and consciousnesses from times past are now flowing through us again because we're relearning some of the things that we lost in the past. And so on the one hand, we need to be really in the current moment. But on the other hand, we need to be really aware. It's almost like we're living in the middle of this enormous spiral, and we sort of have to have a sense of ourself kind of at the point where that spiral takes off. And we also have to be able to really tune into and feel all of these other realities because they are affecting us and they are happening. They're happening to all of us. They're happening to us as a group as well as individuals. Yes. And so we have to really start to become much, much more aware of what these other realities actually are. We need to work at defining them. We need to work at what dimension they're operating in, because there are many, many realities that are in other dimensions that are actually right with us in this room right now.
Right.
There's all kinds of spirits and master teachers working with us at this moment in time, but they're not in physical bodies, these particular ones. They're in other dimensions.
Mm-hmm. And people would find that hard to believe, Barbara. You know,
right.
We've had so many lies in our history, so
right.
many false belief systems,
right.
that we don't believe that we have a personal access to divinity, but we do. This
right.
has been. Can we talk about the lies of the history and that have influenced
mm-hmm.
influenced us?
We could go over thousands and thousands of years, but especially during the last 2,000 years, there's been a control program that's been operating through religions and through political systems. And at some point in time, and again, thousands of years, but at some point in time, the people who have a large amount of influence in our lives, political people or people with a lot of money, realized that if they were going to control us, they needed to gradually wean us away from being in touch with the spiritual reality.
Absolutely.
Because if you think of it, if you're in touch with your own personal reality and then very much in touch with the spiritual realm, no one can control you. And so there's been a process operating it. I wrote a lot about it in my latest book called Catastrophobia,
yes.
Where I'm especially working on the last 2,000 years, because at the current moment, we're coming to the end of the age of Pisces, which has been like a 2,000-year age of
yes.
experiencing religions and learning to move to a more profound level with our emotional bodies. And as we come out of the age of Pisces and as we move into the age of Aquarius, we're learning how to work with energy in a new way, and we're learning how to work with dimensions in a new way. But as we come to this point, and we're here right now, mm-hmm. all of the old emotional stuff and all of the programs and all of the control patterns are just hitting us like a ton of bricks.
Isn't
that
true?
I mean, like, look at the political situation in the United States, you know, with
yes.
the current election.
You call them the men from Orion, or the world management team.
The world management
team, the men
yeah.
in dark suits,
that's
white
right.
shirts and red ties, isn't
that's
that true?
That's right. I mean, look in the latest political scene, the dark suits and the red ties. It's absolutely incredible.
Yes.
If they knew what we were saying, maybe they wouldn't wear them anymore. And so I think that we all need to start to realize that as these large forces are affecting us in our lives, like it's such a peculiar election, it would be a very good example, there actually are energy forces behind this process. In other words, like when I observed the latest presidential election, I was watching it from the point of view of many, many dimensions. And for example, probably shouldn't say this on TV,
please,
but I will.
We need to have courage
George
to speak,
Bush
as you said.
Must
Let's
be
say.
Julius Caesar, if you look at Roman history and you look at the role that Julius Caesar played. And so it not only might be valuable to start to understand, because I, of course, do believe that we are here now, but we have been here many, many times before. We've played out many, many roles. And why is that important? Because it's fun. First of all, it's fun. But secondly,
but people find that hard to believe, Barbara,
well,
in our day, because
exactly,
of the one you,
exactly.
You say a one life mentality is it kills Earth.
Well, right. We've had 1,500 years now of first of all, let's go back to 500 A.D. and the Roman Catholic Church became the basic religious in terms of Western civilization. There are other religions, obviously, and so reincarnation and belief in past lives, first of all, is a belief system for about 60 or 70% of the people on the planet at the current time, in China or in India, say. And so regarding Western civilization and Western religion, reincarnation was written out of doctrine and was declared a heresy in 500 A.D. But what's important to recognize is up until 500 A.D., Christians and Christianity also believed in past lives. Now, why is this important? Well, if you go into other spiritual traditions and other world religions, one of the things that goes on with reincarnation, it isn't just about identifying who your past lives are, because really, who cares? But what's interesting about reincarnation is identifying all the things you've already learned. In other words, when a baby is born, a baby is not a clean slate. And I have four children, and I can assure you that my children were not a clean slate. They came in with all sorts of memories and all sorts of
background. Well, you, Barbara, too. Look at your life. I love the way you take us on your personal journey.
Right.
Through how you healed.
That's right.
The woman part of you, the goddess part of you, and all these
That's
other
right.
things.
That's right. Referring to my trilogy, yeah. The Mind Chronicles. And
the Mind Yes.
Eye of the Centaur is actually my second book, but it's really my first book in terms of my current career, because my first book was back in 1976, and it was about methods for making stained glass windows, so it's not part of this phase of my career. And so Eye of the Centaur is my first book of the trilogy regarding past life regression. And the reason I wrote Eye of the Centaur was when I was 38 years old, I was the mother of four children, and the wife of a very wonderful man, and the only problem
Jerry
was I was cracking up in the midlife crisis. I wrote another book about midlife crisis.
Right.
And so I was cracking up, literally cracking up, in the sense that I found I had all of these voices inside me that were just screaming for attention. Now, first of all, had been at home for 18 years, raising four children and changing pants, and we all know what that's like. Not everybody knows what it's like, but clearly it can get you to the point where you're screaming inside. And so I decided that if I went to do past life regression under hypnosis, I came up with the idea that all of these voices inside of that were screaming might be a whole bunch of my past lives. I mean, how did I know?
Right.
So I went and did eventually 100 sessions under hypnosis, and I brought all of these past lives into my current reality. Mm-hmm. And what would be the point of that besides it being so fascinating? Because it was fascinating. What I did was I then reached a point where I had integrated everything I had known up until this moment in time, and then I was able to accelerate from that point forward.
Right.
And then I discovered later that this is actually a world spiritual tradition. In other words, that for thousands and thousands of years, different cultures on the planet, especially with master teachers, have, like many of the master teachers, have gone through not necessarily hypnosis, but sort of more the type of therapy where you just kind of like memory therapy, mm-hmm. where they bring back that rich tradition of experience they've already had on the earth.
Right.
And it, to me, Audrey, it's profoundly ecological. Uh-huh. Because I don't think we'd be destroying the planet right now if people really understood that they come back again and again.
Well, these are sacred principles. Mm-hmm. These are indigenous principles. These are primal principles.
That's right.
You say we need to go to these principles to save ourselves.
That's right.
Which is true. And now, fascinating that science is now proving what the indigenous people said. And even your grandfather had said, one day he will speak these truths.
That's right.
When science can prove it. I mean, we have physics and the holographic universe and matter is frozen light by goober. I mean, this is all incredible because we need that. Our world needs that. Right.